Hey, Dad.
Hi, how are you doing?
Good. Do you want to talk about the magic of refrigeration today?
The magic of air conditioning, yes.
Yes.
But basically, right. A typical air conditioning system here in Kansas, you know, most people have a furnace. It's down in the basement. And down in the basement, your furnace consists of a blower and then of course, part of your furnace heats the air, but then sitting on top of the furnace, there is a cooling coil, a coil. And the other component to the air conditioner is your air conditioner out in the yard. We call that a condenser coil, a condensing unit, but it has a coil, a condenser coil, as well as a compressor and a fan motor in the unit outside. And that coil is tied directly via these refrigerant lines to the coil that's down in your basement. Okay, so there's actually a loop from the coil down in the basement all the way loops to the unit outside and then back inside again. Okay, so we've got your furnace downstairs that has this cooling coil on top of it. It's tied to the unit outside that is called a condenser coil, a condensing unit, they call it. And when your thermostat says, hey, the house is getting hot, it sends out two signals. The first signal is sent to the unit outside, the condensing unit, and it turns on the compressor, which is really just like a pump. Think of it as a pump. And it starts circulating refrigerant through that coil outside, and it sends it inside and circulates it through that coil and then back outside again. So it's just circulating refrigerant through those two coils. It turns on a fan outside. And then the second thing it does, it sends a signal down to the furnace to turn on the blower. And so the furnace blower comes on, and now we're gathering all the warm, humid air up in the house via the return air grills. And it draws in all the, brings in all the warm, humid air from the home, sends it downstairs where it then accelerates it up through this coil that's downstairs, this evaporator coil, and it absorbs the heat out of the air. It takes the heat out of the air and absorbs it into the refrigerant that it's circulating through that coil. It is then pumped outside where we now have another coil outside and that fan, and we reject the heat outside in the yard. So if in the summertime, the air conditioner is working, did you ever go outside and put your hand above the air conditioner and feel the air?
Yes.
Coming off of it? Yes. And that air was what?
Hot.
Hot. Correct. That's actually heat out of the house. Okay, so we're circulating refrigerant through these two coils, and we're absorbing heat out of the house, and we're rejecting it out in the yard outside. Okay, so we just continue that cycle until the thermostat says, hey, it's cool enough in here, and it shuts everything off and waits to do it all over again. Obviously, it gets a little more complicated than that. We're changing pressures and the state of the refrigerant. But basically what it's doing, it's absorbing heat out of the air through the magic of refrigeration. We're absorbing the heat out of the air and we're displacing it outside. You know, think of it much like your refrigerator. You ever think of your refrigerator? What the refrigerator is doing is it's taking heat out of the inside of the box, which makes it colder, and it displaces it outside the box. So, you know, most people can relate. I go, do you ever put your hand down on the floor or behind your refrigerator?
And just around it, yeah.
Yeah, it's hot. Exactly. Mm-hmm. That's heat out of your milk and eggs and hamburger. Mm-hmm. And we take the heat out of that space, which makes it colder, and we put it in the kitchen, which makes it warmer, which makes your kitchen warmer. Well, that's what the air conditioner does. It's taking heat out of your house and displaces it and puts it out in the yard. So it makes your home.
Okay, cool. And then you can also, like how we've said before, you can treat the air with filters and things like that so that it's not only cooler, but it's cleaner.
Right.
Makes it better for allergies. And
so that little drawing that you show there, you know, shows the furnace filter in the system. And yes, you can have a cheap little, you know, dime store type filter, grocery store kind of filter, or you can actually put a high efficiency air cleaner in there. So now as mm-hmm. we're circulating the air, we can remove all the particles out of the air.
Right.
We can also clean the air and freshen the air by introducing ultraviolet light, you know, into the system, mm-hmm. you know. So yeah, but the really cool part is when that air conditioner is working, it's also dehumidifying. So that coil that's downstairs on top of your furnace is cold. And it, and mm-hmm. we're taking heat out of that air, so we're also taking moisture out of the air, much like, you know, when you set an iced tea glass out, you know, when the air hits something cold, it mm-hmm. condenses moisture. You know, we talked about that before, about, you know, how, what happens to your air conditioner when it has a leak or something like that. Well, mm-hmm. when it's operating properly, we're taking a lot of moisture out of the air, and so that helps make it feel more comfortable as well. So we want that unit outside to be clean. You know, it's outside. Mm-hmm. It's operating in a rather dirty environment. So, mm-hmm. so cottonwood seeds from the trees or dirt and dust, you know, all those kinds of things we want to wash out. We want to keep them clean. We want to keep your return air grills open inside the house, and keep as many registers as you can open inside the house, because we need to circulate air through there, mm-hmm. you know. So yeah, free movement of air both inside and outside is really important for the air conditioner.
Okay, great. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much.
You bet.